Like, we've just been going through city, after town, after village. We really haven't gone through a lot of countryside. Google is taking us through the Roman ruins. Nobody knows why, but they're doing it nonetheless.
Quite a first destination is the Roman ruins.
TV. اختفوا. ما بعرف شو صار معه. الممثل جون دكاش هاي.
So this weekend, Valentine and I are heading out of Beirut for the first time, and we're gonna try to see if we can do a little weekend excursion. So Valentine just picked up the car. Apparently it's a pretty cool car.
What?
I said apparently it's a pretty cool car.
Yeah, it's a great car.
It's tiny and really awesome. Great for the streets of Beirut.
We got a sleeping kitty. Not sleeping anymore. Vendors.
All right. This store is open.
Oh. New stores are opening up like every day. People are just kind of getting sick of the lockdown that's been going on for about a month now, so they're just opening. Oh, this is our car. Nice.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Still getting the hang of it, but it's working.
What's working?
Like the city driving.
Was it difficult?
Well, so like the rules are a bit different. They are not quite, like they don't really, you kind of have to figure out when you want to go. You know, people don't like automatically wait for you. Or there's not, people don't work, like lights are so like kind of guidelines, not strict. So you just because you have a green light, it doesn't mean that they're gonna let you go. So you have to still check.
Yeah. Well, strap in. Sounds like it's gonna be quite an adventure.
Yeah.
Just getting out of the city alone.
You just go when you are, when it is convenient.
I saw you use the honk maneuver.
Yeah, you need to.
Make sure that they know you're there.
Yeah. Not as bad as you do. Lebanon feels really free with a car. right. That's a good way to...
Maybe go around.
Right here.
Yeah, right around.
Perfect.
Cool. So, the first order of business before we even start going to Baalbek is to get some of our US dollars exchanged, because we're not sure if the hotel is going to give us a good rate, but we know that our Western Union guy will.
So we're gonna exchange some dollars.
Yeah.
Take some. Change it.
Mm-hmm. 8.5.
8.5. That's the best I can get. 500 or 4?
4.
3 minutes.
Yara Gazi.
I like, didn't expect
Gazi?
Yes.
A dog. How's the business doing?
Thank you so much.
How's the business? So cute.
Let's get out of here.
All right. That was easy?
Hey, you had some,
he has like 10% like alcohol.
Why not?
Yes.
Pick up some beer?
Yeah.
You want to
go get that?
I'll see if I can pick up. Okay. So, I guess, well, you know, the Western Union sells kind of just about everything, so I'm going to see if I can get some beer. This one's so good up at the top here. Beirut beer. Maza. I think I'll do Beirut beer because we haven't tried it yet.
Beirut beer?
We haven't tried this one yet.
Alright.
Right?
Yeah. 5%. Awesome.
Alright, now let's get going.
Can I get a mask?
You can. There's just random splits.
Wow, look at that. The city, the mountains. As soon as you leave the city, if you're going east, you'll hit the mountains. And so we've started into the very hilly terrain that they have up here. For the total of 4 days, yeah. And
we got full insurance for it.
We got covered for two drivers.
Yeah,
both
two
of
drivers.
Us. budget car rental, like a reputable car rental company.
Yeah, and it's a new car.
Yeah, it's
only
very
like 18,000 miles on it.
It's a very nice car.
It drives great.
Mm-hmm.
It's a brand new car. I mean, like, it's brand new clean.
You know, it's seen the Becca Mountains, though, so, you know.
The guy is gonna help us clean.
We agreed. Even though I have no small change. But we agreed.
I think I have some, like, 1,000s.
Nice.
One turkey and cheese, yeah. And do you want anything to drink?
Yeah, like ice.
I want ice caramel latte.
Do you have an ice caramel latte? Which do you want?
Small.
And like an ice latte small for me.
No flavor?
No flavor.
Two ice latte, one with caramel, one without.
And
This is the guy that washed our...
That washed our car.
Yeah, he washed our car. In the back.
And I told him, I said I did this, which means wait.
Mm-hmm.
Because I only have like some big change right now, and I want to wait until I pay for the food and drinks before I give him his payment.
Emily is definitely feeling nervous with this guy around waiting. Because he's definitely waiting, you know.
He's just kind of staring at us. It's making me feel uncomfortable.
We got the sandwich, which looks really good actually.
Nice. Sandwich. Warm.
Anything else, ladies? 46,000, please.
Okay.
You want straws?
Or no, no this is a. Cups.
Oh god. They're the sippy cups.
Okay.
Guys, move. Just move. Come on. Like, bro.
So this was Starbucks.
This was the Starbucks.
Starbucks experience.
They're like literally standing in front of the car. Mafi. Dalla. She's like literally on the car. Well, that happened.
She's just like throwing herself. She's just throwing herself on the car. Like, oh my god.
That's definitely a first for me. I have never experienced anything like that. They were across the street, or they were like farther down in the driveway, drive-through area, just kind of sitting around. And as soon as we gave the payment to the guy who cleaned the car, they came running over. And it was just, they looked like they were related to that guy.
They did. Oh, and then this guy's going the other way. Cause that happens.
You thought it's a one-way road? Think again.
This might be a check, you think?
I'm not sure.
No, it's different.
That's not Mr. Clean, that's the Michelin man.
It's not Mr. Clean.
No, that's the Michelin man.
Who's the Michelin man?
It's like a fingerprint thing, I think.
It's not a checkpoint. It was just a bunch of traffic. We put on masks for nothing.
Well, better safe than sorry, I think.
Safe and COVID-free. It's just been like this the whole way. There's no Belarus was empty like the whole time. Like yeah. There was nothing, and there would be just a cafe. Tourists. There would be a cafe every like 20 kilometers.
Mm-hmm. Here it's just thing after thing after thing.
country feels dense.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Michelin. It's a tire guy.
Oh, yeah. Michelin Man's a tire guy.
More people driving the other way.
Jesus.
So I think the reason why they're driving the wrong way on the right side here is because you can't exactly cross to the correct side of the road very easily. Like, there aren't many openings to that, to the other lane of traffic from this side. So if you have to turn around, you know, it makes it difficult. You'll see a lot of banners and like statue or like figurines of these Hezbollah main members kind of just around in the villages. Usually in areas that they control, you'll see that. Is there a shoe on the back of that guy's car?
Oh wow, this is gorgeous. Look at these trees. Alright, so we're arriving into the center of Baalbek. Now we need to set the destination of our hotel.
So we're in Baalbek. Baalbek, Baalbek, Baalbek. Who knows what that means?
There wasn't really a transition to get into Baalbek, nor does it look any different than the rest of Lebanon.
It's just Baalbek now. The streets are a little bit narrower.
Yep. Everything's closed, but...
Actually, I've been seeing a lot of stores that are open.
Yeah, all the stores are kind of open.
Like, I saw a lot of clothing stores that were open.
Mm-hmm.
I heard that they do things a little differently over here in Baalbek, so... Where do I go now?
Around and... Ideals. I guess they're ideals over here. This guy.
He's not even looking at me. He knows I'm here.
He just is aware. He's got the unagi.
Right in the middle of the city.
It's like the city is built around.
Oh.
Or, you know, at least maybe they used to be functional buildings. Do you think they were used to be government?
No. It's the, I don't know, they're temples, I think. So. Thank you.
don't know where the hell this hotel is.
Yeah, we parked kind of close to where it says the hotel is on the map, and we're just gonna walk and try to find it. So, let's go. We found it.